Yo, what's going on, guys? Manny here, and today what I have for you is some footage of the new team that I'm playing for, Barkingside, playing in the FA Cup. I don't want to talk over this like I would Sunday League, because I don't want to make it like a Sunday League thing at all. But this is just so you guys sort of know how my progress is going on in the semi-professional direction. And just, yeah, just the background of that, really. So yeah, the other day we had FA Cup. I think it's one of the first preliminary rounds, maybe even the first, I'm not too sure. But we were drawn against Leighton Athletic, and the first game was a home game. Unfortunately, on my way to this game, because of complications, I got there late and I was supposed to be starting. As a result of getting there late, I couldn't start and I ended up on the bench, which is normal. Any manager would do that. That's normal. I expected to be on the bench coming that late, because if you don't get there for the meet time, your starting position, if you are in the starting 11, is always in jeopardy. So yeah, anyway, not in the starting lineup, normal, expected. The game starts, it goes on, and there wasn't really too much happening. We come in at halftime, 0-0. Manager pulls me to the side, tells me that I'll be going on shortly. So I know that I'm going to start the second half, and my job really, coming on in the 10 role, is to try and make little things happen. Honest opinion, I wouldn't say I struggled to do that, but sometimes it's hard to come into a game and impact it in the way that you'd want to with the pitch as well. Not the greatest, very hard to play on, but you play the conditions as you're told, really. And if I'm honest, I would give my performance a 5 out of 10. I'll roll the clips in a second from that first game. And yeah, I tried to get on the ball when I could, but I think I didn't get into the game quickly enough to affect it well enough or as well as I would have liked. And yeah, that pretty much summed it up. But the first game, so that game ended 0-0. The closest chance we came to scoring might have actually been my attempt. It might have actually been my attempt from just the edge of the box. Keeper comes out, blah, blah, blah. Comes out and I take a first time shot, just try to control it and it goes just over the bar. So I think that might have been the closest that we came to scoring, I'm not too sure. But yeah, pretty drab game. We know that we didn't perform to our abilities and we're still yet to to score a goal, really. So I don't know, something needs to change.
Bang, 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 bang
From my point of view, fitness level, I would say, is about 75%. Match sharpness, I would say, is about 50%. I wouldn't say that I'm match sharp. I'm not used to match situations and stuff like I should be. Like, I should be a lot sharper, a lot on the ball, and I feel like I'm not there yet. It's going to take me 2, 3, maybe 4 more games to get to the level that I would like to be in terms of sharpness. But I'm going to keep doing my stuff in my own time, stuff on the side that I feel will help me improve and get sharper and just a level above some of the other players on the pitch. So I'm going to keep doing my stuff on the side in the time that I have, although that's very limited, and we'll see where it gets me. But yeah, for that game, I'll say 5 out of 10. Match fitness, I would say 75%, and match sharpness, I'd say 50. I've got a long way to go. Moving on to the next game, as a result of drawing, we had to play a replay, and literally, I've come back from that replay today. I don't want to spoil it for you sort of thing, but I'm going to spoil it for you. We've lost 3-0, and I'm just going to give you my perspective of the game, how I think it went. We started off quite well, we were controlling the game, I was finding pockets for myself, playing in the 10 role again, this time on number 7 though. I was playing in little pockets, finding space, trying to get on the ball as and when I could. They weren't making it easy, to be fair, so as soon as I got the ball, they were on my touch. I felt like I dealt with it well first half, controlled the ball, would set it off or either keep it or just play it off somewhere. And I thought I was doing quite well. I was trying to make little runs here and there, just inject that little bit of pace and creativity that a 10's supposed to inject into the game. And I would say things were going quite well. So it's 0-0, we're controlling the game, we've got a lot of the ball, we're putting them under pressure at times, but we're not really quite doing much in the final third. There was one where I think Santos cut in and hit the post, hit off the goalkeeper, and it just about stayed out of the goal. But I don't know, other than that, in the first half, I wouldn't say we had any clear-cut chances. I think some of that's on me, some of that's on the rest of the team, and from my perspective, yet again, I think we need to do a lot more. I need to do a lot more. And to be fair, first few games of the season, it's a learning curve. I'm hoping that we improve. But yeah, we're 0-0, and then all of a sudden, they counter-attack. I'm not sure how it works. Gets into the box, we fail to clear it really. I didn't really get back as quickly as I could have, didn't really get tight to anyone in the box. I'm not saying it's my fault, but I feel like I could have done a little more just to like have a presence in the box and maybe try and stop them from getting a shot off. But also saying that at the same time, it's hard to get from one end of the pitch back consistently when you're trying to make runs to put pressure on them. On the other side, it's very difficult to keep that same intensity when going back. But yeah, the ball fell to, I think, their number 10 in the box. He was allowed to turn and he shot it hard and low. And against the run of play, they were 1-0 up. So from that, our heads went down a little bit. We didn't really get the reaction that we should have had. We didn't really react and come back and say we're 1-0 down, we're still in this game, let's go at it. And again, I feel like I could have done a little more on that side of things to maybe try and take the game forward to our opposition. But I don't know, it's like I said, my match sharpness isn't there. I'm still trying to get back into the groove of playing football and playing football with a bit of tempo. So yeah, we're going at half time and we all know that it's disappointing. We should be winning in this game. We should be doing a lot more attacking wise and we shouldn't be 1-0 down. However, that's the situation. It allows them a bit of leeway, a bit of pressure goes off of the opposition. And as a result, they don't have to worry as much. It's now on us to try and get back in the game and do something. In the second half, I got moved out onto the wing. We make a few changes to try and claw this back. We're only 1-0 down, so we're very much in a position where we can. However, it didn't really go that way. I was played out on the right wing. I always prefer playing central. I'm not saying I can't play on the wing. I'm not saying I can't beat a man. But this particular game, second half for me, in my honest opinion, if I'm being honest, I can be honest with myself, I won't lie, I won't deceive myself, I think I was poor. Yes, at times I was chasing back and I still had a bit of energy to do that, but I feel like I got leggy and then I got really sloppy, was giving the ball away, wasn't holding it up quite as well as I was doing in the first half, and I felt, looking back at it, it's very disappointing on my part, and Although I'm saying I'm not match sharp, I know I can do a lot better. Even when I'm tired, I can do a lot better than that, but I feel like today will be a lesson to me that I need to do a bit more to keep the intensity up. Even when I'm tired, just the simpler things. When you're tired, the simpler things get harder to do at times, but you can still do them. You can still do them, and I think that's something that I failed to do. So, anyway, we make a little mistake from our keeper. He plays it out wide instead of going short. It goes to their player. He's driving at our players, twisting and turning in our box. He goes down, and it's a penalty. So, although we were very much still in the game, they have a penalty. They go to the keeper's left, bottom right, and just about creeps in. So, it's 2-0, and we have it all to do. We had it all to do, should I say. So, as if it wasn't hard enough at 2-0, we had a lot of work to do, and they knew that. They took that to their advantage. They started to use that to then control the game. Our heads were down a little bit. And from then, they did control the game, really. We had a few half chances, not anything proper. And we failed to get back into the game. For myself, I was very leggy at this point. I also got like a little knock in the back of my calf, which was making it hard for me to run. I still did try and run. I'll never just like give up, really, unless I can't. I don't have anything less to give. That's not in my nature, but... again, I think I could have done a lot more. My quality suffered in the second half. My passing, my crossing, couldn't get the ball out of my feet at times, making a few tired decisions. And yeah, like I said, it is a learning curve. But yeah, we're out of the FA Cup. I'm not saying we're going to go all the way or anything, but it's nice to at least get one win in the FA Cup and be like, yeah, I got a win in the FA Cup. Like, we got that last year with Romford. Unfortunately, this year wasn't the same. But there is a lot of work to be done on my part and the team's part. And hopefully things start to fall into place. But 2-0 up, they were comfortable. And then we got really tired. We were kind of all over the place once we were going to try and get a goal back in the game, as you would expect. And they made it 3-0. We were just a bit out of position. They cut into our box and slotted it home. So 3-0. And yeah, it was very frustrating, but you learn from losing. Sometimes you have to lose in order to come back as a stronger person, stronger player, and also become a winner. Most of the people who win a lot of things have lost a lot before. And I'm hoping that we start to turn things around because it's not looking great right now. Honest ratings for this game, I would say first half, 7 out of 10. I played quite well first half. That's me being honest anyway. Second half, I would say, not even being harsh on myself, yeah, I did do a little few bits here and there, but I would say a 4 out of 10. And I could do a lot better. Now it's time to go back to the drawing board. Go back to doing a little bit of training. And right now I need to have an ice bath because, yeah, my legs are kind of killing. So, yeah. Anyway, guys, we lost 3-0. Wasn't a 3-0 game, in my opinion. But that's how football goes. Sometimes when you're on top, if you don't take advantage, one little thing switches the momentum and the other team goes from there and doesn't look back. That's what happened today. And we're out the FA Cup. But I'm hoping this is not the story of our season. I'm hoping it's not the story of my season. I want a bit more of the 7 out of 10 performances and upwards rather than the 4 or 5 out of 10. That's not good enough. And got a lot of work to do. Anyway, guys, I just wanted to share a bit of my experience, be plain and honest with you. I'm not gonna lie to myself. I'm not gonna come out and be like, oh yeah, like I did this, or like I was the best player on the pitch or anything. Like, I'll be straight up with you. If I play badly, I'll tell you. If I play all right, I'll tell you. If I play well, I'll tell you as well. Simple as that. But hopefully you have enjoyed this. Hopefully if you're playing football and like you've lost the game, or if you can relate to anything like this, just keep going. I guess that's all you can do. Like, after the game, I say I was quite dejected and stuff like that, but it's like, what can you do? Like, the game's done. You go forward, look to the next one and improve. You learn from your mistakes. That's all you can do. But yeah, hopefully you have enjoyed watching this video. Leave a like on it if you have. Subscribe if you are new, and I will talk to you guys in a bit. Peace.